So this is still a relational approach, that the relationship is important, you're setting clear expectations, you're providing support to kind of get, you know, to reach that potential. Mm-hmm. But there's clear boundaries and expectations, and you know, there's that relational approach that supports it.
Right. And what we find in schools that are able to use strength-based practice with very high expectations is you generally find the expectations in this school, for instance, is much higher than other schools in the same community. Students generally, upon coming to the school, would generally indicate that it's very strict and there's very high expectations. What they also say quite early in their time with us is that they seem to get a lot of support and acknowledgement about what they're doing well, which actually motivates them to take more and more risks as they proceed. As they take more and more risk, gain more and more success, they actually start to build that confidence, and actually you'll find that the support they require actually diminishes. So we just choose to put in a lot of work with most of our students really at the start, so they're starting to identify their strengths. They're starting to recognize that there is support there should they be trying their best. So we really look at almost everything in our relationship as information, as an aspect of that relationship, an indication of a strength or an indication of further support. And then we move forward with that student based on that information.
So Don, some schools, some people may define student success as doing well academically and behaving in appropriate ways all the time. Talk to us more about what the process of change has been for your students and your school, and what that means in terms of how you define success for students.
Yeah, I think that a lot of schools look at a compliance. They use compliance as a term to gain success. So, and compliance just means I don't have problems, right? What we use as a gauge is not necessarily compliance. Compliance really doesn't come into it for us because there's multiple ways to gain compliance. Some people believe through power and enforcement. Other people would believe through avoidance. What we're talking about is actually engagement. And I think so we totally avoid the compliance issue altogether. We look at our students engaged in a process of self-development. Do we have the relationships in our building that promote that development for students? Do we understand enough about each other to facilitate experiences and processes and relationships that allow us to grow, learn, and develop? I know that at certain points in time, there's some administrators that really talk about, if I never see a student or never hear from a student, that I'm running an effective school because they're staying out of trouble. I talk to students all day long. I'm actually very involved in the student population. I want to know about students. I want to know what is working for them, what's not working for them, where they're struggling, how I can support them. So when we talk about class exclusions, we actually have appropriate class exclusions, because what we're saying is that right now, whatever result, whatever happening in that scenario has gone beyond somebody in that situation's capacity to deal with the situation, and they need some support around that. Actually, most of the time in our schools, students necessarily aren't really sent to the office. They sometimes request to come for extra support. Oftentimes a teacher will say that it sounds like that is an issue for you or something that you need to discuss, and they know that there are other supports in the school that at that point in time that student needs to access, whether it be school administration because the decision needs to be made that's outside the capacity of that teacher to make it. Potentially it's one of our counselors that we have in the building. Potentially it is an outside agency that needs to support that student in the context of their family, and they need to meet with our student services person in order to start to align some of those processes and those supports. So really it goes then to an advocacy model, right? And what is my ability to advocate within my school for what I need in order to progress? So it doesn't become a compliance issue for us, it becomes an issue of respectful advocacy. As a basis of how we support students, we invest a lot of money or a lot of time, a lot of effort, a lot of expertise in negotiating supports for students that we can see students requiring throughout the year. We recognize that students will meet many challenges if we really are trying to extend their capacity to grow. And if we can be proactive in having the supports available to students when they need the support as opposed to reactive when the crisis occurs, what we find is a challenge for a student can be mitigated and it never gets to crisis. It's certainly a challenge that needs support and some work to move through, but it never hits crises. It never hits that point where growth potentially stops or is on hold, because what you'll find as well is that if you wait for a crisis to occur, the support that's necessary generally is not available to you immediately, mm-hmm. and therefore the crisis gets to exist for a period of time and generally grows. What we also find within that process, oftentimes we lose any ground that we've actually made to that point in time, both in the relationship, mm-hmm. in the person's or the family's self-concept or ability to advocate. Again, it's one of those things, is once we take a risk around change and a risk around support, that's very delicate. And what we try to do is nurture that and continue to support that, because we know it's much more difficult for students and families should they, you know, take a risk in developing significant relationships. Right. Should that bond be challenged, broken, it's much more difficult for them to re-engage, and it takes up a lot more time. Again, it comes back to the model, and we talk about a model here about doing our, we just ask students to do their very best every day, and that's within the structure of a classroom, it's in all of our relationships, it's in your ability to solve an issue. So we really talk about that, and so that's really, even in these circumstances, we really discuss what was that response like? How was that response helpful? Was there something you would change in the future about that response? Mm-hmm. And then also supporting that student through it, yeah. Right? And that's a big thing. And we have more opportunities to do that, we tend to find the students and their families much more effective, much more forthcoming.